Hello everyone, and welcome to another product introduction video. My name is Oliver Draper, CTO for COP. And the product I've got to show you today is the brand new Hikvision 4 megapixel ANPR dome. So it's an ANPR camera, automatic number plate recognition, and it's in a dome format. First time Hikvision have done this. The rest of the ANPR cameras have always been a type of bullet, whether that's the 7 series standard bullet or the TCM camera. Don't forget, obviously, the bollard camera they do as well. This one is a dome. Not only is it ANPR, it can switch to a normal VCA camera for your line crossing intrusion. It's got people loitering detection, people gathering detection, a lot of features in there we'll take a look at in a moment. Not only is it a dome, though, as I mentioned, it actually contains a DarkfighterS technology. So that's a dual-like technology. So what we've got in there, we've got the standard Darkfighter like you'd get on any 7 series camera, but it also has the white light ColorVu technology. Now, they don't refer to this as a hybrid-like camera like we saw in previous videos. The hybrid-like cameras on your 2 and 3 series are ColorVu, along with Powered by Darkfighter, which is Hikvision's entry-level Darkfighter. This one is ColorVu, but it has the true Darkfighter image technology in there, so you get a better image on it. And Hikvision are calling this DarkfighterS. When I spoke to Hikvision, they said it stood for superior. So not only has it got that advanced dual-like technology for color and IR with Darkfighter, but it also contains a feature called PTRZ, pan tilt rotate zoom. So you're familiar with pan tilt zoom cameras where you can pan and tilt them and zoom them in. That does this. Now, it doesn't do that in the conventional sense as a normal dome, which you operate and move around and look at things in a scene as things move around. It's just the initial setup. Now, the additional feature there, as I mentioned, is rotate. So you can have the camera zoomed in, positioned as you want to, and while you're setting it up, you can actually rotate the actual image onto an angle, because again, with ANPR, don't forget, it's all very important that we get the actual plate parallel to the scene as possible. So from an installation point of view, commissioning, it makes things a lot more simple. What we'll do then, we'll pop this out the box, take a look, and just see what it looks like inside. So we're going to pop this out the box and take a look. As we can see, it is part of the DeepinView series, being a 7 series. So we'll just open this up and see what the camera actually looks like. So straight away inside there, you have got your mounting template, which you can use underneath this bit of foam. We have the actual camera inside itself. So let me just pop the camera out. We'll come back to the box in a moment. But this is it. As you can see, it is a fairly decent sized bit of kit. So it is a pan tilt rotate zoom camera that does actually move, as we can see. The camera itself does have 2 microphones on there. It also has the audio out. If we look at the connectors on the back, what we've got here, again, we've got a mountain of cables there. We have actually got a standard Ethernet port there, RJ45. We've got a coaxial port there as well, which is your connecting, obviously, for testing to see exactly the image on the screen as you're actually set it up. You've got your audio input outputs. We've got our 12-volt input. We've got 12-volt output as well. We've got WiGand. We've got RS485. And we've got our alarm inputs and outputs as well. So we've got a mountain of cables on here. Now, just put that to one side. If we take a look at the box, we do have the mounting bracket inside there as well as your usual connectors and quick start guides and bits and pieces. Now, this is what I found quite interesting when I took this out of the box. Obviously, you can see on the plate there, it says the word front, so you know if you're going to mount this onto somewhere, you know which way it's going to be facing forward. Brilliant. Or if you're going to be putting it onto a wall, we turn it over, we've got the word up if we're wall mounting it. So again, we've got it if it's going to be ceiling mounted or if it's going to be wall mounted. Little hook there is obviously what you hook on the actual steel cable. So when you're actually mounting it, obviously you can hang that from there whilst you're actually putting it in place. Now, what I did like about this, so imagine this is obviously ceiling mounted as it is there. We've got the little clips on either side there, as we can see here and here. So imagine that's been mounted to your ceiling. All you would do is once that's mounted in place, is you position this as you need to, and then it's just a simple click in place. And that's then clicked and secured in place. From an installation point of view, it makes it very simple and straightforward to actually mount it. Once you've actually clicked that in place and that's held, as you can see there, we have got our security screw, which we just tighten to ensure that won't come off. So it does make it very quick and easy to actually install this in place. And then you've got the 2 little buttons either side. Press those 2 buttons. That then releases that plate, which I'll just pull this off here now just for a second, so we can see. And very straightforward. Now, one thing you may notice, yes, as we talked about, there is a bunch of cables there. If you are going to ceiling or wall mount this, they have got to go through the wall. That's quite a lot to put through a wall and a decent sized hole you've got to put in. However, we look at the side here, There is a rubber bung. We take that off. That can then mount flush, and you don't have to worry about putting loads of holes in the wall if you need to, and you could potentially use some sort of trunking or whatever you're using to actually secure that there. So what we'll do, we're going to log into this camera and take a look and see what it can do.
So I'm at the main login page of this camera now. I've already activated by giving it a password, and I've given it an IP address. Again, you've seen this on previous videos. We don't need to go through that again. So I'm just going to log straight into the camera, as I normally would do. Click login. And don't forget, other than that, the camera is basically brand new, fresh out of the box. So when we log into here now, as you can see, it's currently pointing towards the ceiling because then you can see on the other image I'm showing your screen now, the camera has just been plugged in, and that's its sort of default position at the moment. So I'm going to go across to configuration first of all, and we'll take a look at some of the configuration settings. So on the system settings there, straight away we can see the model number just there. So it is an IDS, meaning it's got that intelligence in there. 2 CDIP camera, 7 series, 4 meaning, 5 meaning it's a dome, the 4 meaning 4 megapixel, 7 is got that Darkfighter technology, and don't forget that slash P in there indicates it's got ANPR. Now this is the also interesting bit here, is that X we're seeing towards the end there. That X there is indicating it's got that hybrid light technology. As I mentioned, they're not calling this one a smart hybrid light, they're calling it more of a dual light technology because it's got the true Darkfighter along with ColorVu. Z, motorized varifocal lens. H is for ETA. S is for intake of audio and alarm. And the Y at the end indicates it's got an anti-corrosion level in there. So if we go across on this section here, we've got our usual time settings in there. Again, it is brand new, fresh out the box. I'm just going to sync that with my local time currently at the minute. Got our daylight saving input in there. RS232 if we're using that. RS45 if we're using that. The metadata is set to road traffic because by default of the box, this is set as an ANPR camera. We can even put in the location as well for the longitude and latitude should we wish to. And our WiGand connection is also there as well. All of the settings we go down the left-hand side are more or less the same as any other camera, really. Nothing, any major differences, really. Your network stuff's the same. Your advanced details, again, are more or less the same. What you get on majority of these DeepinView cameras. Video and audio, as I jump into there. As we can see, what it's currently set to by default out of the box, I can knock that onto the high level of 4 megapixel. I'm going to put that on 265 encoding, which is better for bandwidth as such. So as we go across, we've got the option there for audio. This is where we can change the input and output audio settings. So the input volume is using, again, is it going to use what sort of format encoding are we using? The input volume, we can increase that there. The audio output is built-in speaker, or are we using the line out, which needs a built-in speaker? And we can also set what the actual volume is, as well as an environmental noise feature. Region of interest and also target cropping are features we can use on here as well. So let's jump to the image settings and take a look at these. Display image settings, again, are relatively the same as what you get on a normal IP camera. You probably notice the image is quite dark. We've got these lines that are appearing, and that'll be because it's set to an ANPR camera, and it's these exposure settings that are causing this. So already straight away out the box, it's set a lot of the image parameters ready for a typical ANPR scenario. Again, the exposure set to 1 over 1,000, which is fine, and the gain is down to 20. Again, we've got our focus settings, our day and night switch. And as you see, if you recall, again, I'll pop the link in the top right-hand corner. When we did the ANPR setup, these settings are pretty much what we would have on a typical ANPR camera. As we go across from the display settings, we've got the on-screen display. Because it's ANPR, we can also set the tilt angle on there as well as a display, because don't forget with the ANPR cameras, we have that maximum 30-degree rule, as I mentioned on the ANPR video I did not too long ago. And we've got our privacy mask setting, as we can see there. And as we go across, we've got the option for picture overlay. So what this allows me to do is I can upload a picture of your company logo onto there. So when you're on the live view, you see your company logo in the top corner. It could be in the customer's logo, it depends. Fairly simple to do so. You just click on the browser and obviously upload your BMP image. It does have to be smaller than 128 pixels by 128 pixels. That's a maximum you can go to. Once I pop that in there, I can choose to upload that by clicking the upload button. You can't see it because my image is in the bottom right corner, but I've had a pop-up there in the bottom right corner saying upload succeeded, and all I got to do now is enable that and click save, and that will then place. And as we can see there, the little logo has appeared in the top right-hand corner. Finally, as we go across to image parameter switch, this is where throughout the year we can change the image settings to change from one type of image setting to another. So if we go back to display image settings, we can see at the minute it's set to normal. And I can tweak these settings on the right and save them to a particular scene. once I've done that, image prompt switch, I can then set it to change throughout the year should I want to. Go across to PTZ on the left now. Yes, as I mentioned, this is a PTRZ camera, but it's not a PTZ camera in the sense of like a normal dome where you would actually use it to track and move it around and obviously use it as and when you wanted to. The PTRZ feature is just for your initial setup. So we can see there the self-checking state is set to initialized. All you've got to do is enable a self-check, click the self-test, and that's just going to initialize the camera. So we'll just give that a moment or two just to complete what it has to do. As we can see on the other image I've got on the screen at the moment, you will see that the image, the actual PTRZ camera is moving around now just to do that self-initialized test. Once I've done that, I can go to PTRZ next to it. So we can see where the camera is currently pointing to at the moment. This is where I've got the option to rotate that should I wish to. And obviously get this into position however I needed that camera to be positioned. And then you've got your zoom feature there as well. So as you can see, rotate it around, zoom it in, zoom it out, however you would need to do. We'll go to event on the left-hand side. This is where we've got our basic events there. So you've got your standard conventional motion detection, video tampering, alarm input, alarm outputs, your exception detections. Audio alarm output by default is set to siren for 5 times. There are up to 10 pre-recorded phrases built into the camera you can select should you wish to. And as always, you can also upload your custom audio file on there as an option as well. Also, as a feature as well to actually diagnose issues whenever sort of your video quality is deteriorating, whether or not it's a protective film that's not been removed, or the video has been tampered with, or there's a blurred scene. So again, you can get the camera to alert you if anything goes wrong with the image. And then finally, we've got vibration detection. So this can be enabled, and this is if someone is going to be tampering with the camera, sort of bashing it or trying to vandalize it, the camera again can give you that alert back. Now, if we go to Smart Event, there's not a lot there. We've got the audio exception detection. So again, it can trigger an alert should the audio increase to a certain level. We've got a defocus and a sudden scene change. Again, if someone is manually repositioning the camera. But there's not a lot over in Smart Event. The reason being is because by default, it's set to an ANPR camera and all the features are saved under the VCA section. So if I go to VCA in the top, at the top there, we can see it is set to road traffic by default. We can put it to smart event, and then that just turns off the ANPR feature and makes it your normal DeepinView series camera. We'll take a look at that in a short while. VCA general settings, there's not a lot you need to do in there because then it's just got the camera name and camera numbers. But if we go to road traffic, and this is where we have all of our road traffic parameters. So you saw this in the previous video, again, links in the top right hand corner, which shows you how to configure an ANPR camera correctly. So you set all these features depending on what you need to do. Again, your arming schedule linkage methods, your picture settings, your advanced parameters, your allow list and block list, and your vehicle counting statistics. So this is a quite a nifty feature on this camera here. As you can see, we can set the camera to actually count vehicles in and out. In the past, you would have needed some back-end VMS software to do that. The camera can now count vehicles in and out on the camera itself. And you can see there, is it going to be just an automobile, which is going to be normal vehicles? Is it motorbikes as well, or just motorbikes? So you can select what it's to be, and then you've got your on-screen display overview. So you can say, right, I want that to be positioned here, or I want it positioned there. It is by default. So your actual counting information is displayed on the screen as well. And then you can also set it to actually reset a certain time, so you can manually reset it. So after, in this case, at midnight, it will reset back to zero. Here is where you can set, obviously, your flow overlay. Is it forward or reverse, or is it all? Which one is it going to be? And then you've got your option for real-time upload, so we can upload it in real-time, if that's what it needs to be. So what we're going to do now, we're going to change the parameters camera, and we're going to look at it from a point of view of being a normal smart event camera. And all we've got to do is go to VCA resource at the top corner there and change it to smart event and click save. What's happening there, as you can see, it says the device will need to reboot after changing the settings. Continue, and I'm going to click OK. That's now switching the resource and the camera will have to reboot. So we'll just give that a moment or two just to reboot. Okay, camera's rebooted now, as you saw. I've just cut that part of the scene out. Obviously, you guys don't need to sit there for a few minutes while it reboots. So I'm just going to log back into the camera again with the details I've previously set up. Go to log in, and it'll probably put me back to the VCA section if I click on the VCA at the top. Let's have a look. Okay, so again, you can see there it is set to smart events. If I go to smart events on the left, and these are all the various settings we have. We've got our intrusion detection, again, human on vehicle analysis. We've got line crossing, region entering, region exiting, loitering detection, people gathering detection, people running detection, parking detection, unattended baggage, and object removal. So a multitude of features this camera can actually do. So what I can do if I just position the camera, again, the easiest way I found is going to live view. Once I'm in live view, I can use the PTZ control functions on the side there just to position the camera into whatever place I want to. So I can move it around as I normally would do with any other sort of ANPR camera. Because of this camera obviously is set on a tabletop at the minute, as you can see, it's sort of upside down at the moment. But that's not a major issue, because once I've done this, what I can do, I can't actually flip the image at the minute. It just means some of my settings are going to be back to front in a moment. So once I've done that, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go to configuration and just flip that image, because again, normally wouldn't table mount, obviously, a camera like this. It would be usually mounted on a sort of wall mount, on a wall mount bracket, or just mounted straight onto the wall itself. So if I just go to my image settings, I should be able to flip this image here. If I go to my video adjustments, and I want to mirror that to the center, and there we go, that looks the right way up in my scenario. Now, so when I was in live view, which I'll just go back to now, as we say, I have got the PTZ functions on the right, so I would just simply position this into wherever I needed this camera to actually be. Now, once I've done that, as we can see, it is off a little bit, and we can see the tilt is off. All I would need to do is go to my configuration, and then if I go to the left-hand side to PTZ, this is where I could choose to rotate the image on the PTRZ section to try and make it as parallel as possible to the scene. So just wait for that image just to come up, and I can just use these buttons here, and as you can see, I can just rotate those how I need, and I go, yeah, that's about right, that's what I'm wanting for my image. Again, if you are not getting a decent image settings, again, the other things you've got are your video and audio, where you can actually change the resolution of the camera, what it's going to be, and you can also increase sort of the bit rate of what you want the camera to be operating at as well. So when I go to my live view, let's take a look and just see what it currently looks like. I'm just going to click the play button in the bottom right-hand corner, so we can just see what the image looks like. And there we go, we've got our screen at the moment. It is a little bit out of focus at the moment, but you have got your focusing buttons there in the top corner there. And as you can see, I can just click close and bring them into focus depending on what my scene needs to be. And that looks fairly in focus now. If I go back to configuration, just like the hybrid light cameras, because this has got this mixed light of color and Darkfighter, if I go to the image settings, by default, out of the box, this camera is set to white light mode, as we can see there, for the supplement light, meaning once it gets dark in this room, it won't use the IR, it will use the white light for the ColorVu technology. I can say, yep, just use the IR if I want to, use the mixed light or the smart light. So mixed light is in there as an option, or if I go to smart, what the smart light feature means is when an event occurs, whether it be a line cross, intrusion detection, or whatever happens there at that point, it will then go from the black and white IR version into the ColorVu version. I'll just throw a little video on the screen now from the hybrid light camera. As you can see on there, as I walked up my driveway, what happens at that point, I trigger the line crossing, which was where the back tire was, and it flicked to color. And then the idea being, once I leave the scene, it goes back to the IR black and white version. So this camera has that same feature. Again, don't forget, they're not calling these cameras hybrid light. They're calling it the DarkfighterS technology.
So there we go, everyone. A really great bit of kit, as you can see there. A pan, tilt, rotate, zoom, ANPR dome. Don't forget, it has that mixed IR and ColorVu technology, therefore known as DarkfighterS. With the fact it's a dome and obviously it's an ANPR with that pan, tilt, rotate, zoom, as we discussed, it does mean you've got various mounting options. You can ceiling mount this if you wanted to. If you haven't got a canopy to install onto, there is a wall mount, overhang wall mount bracket we do. Pop the image on the screen now there for you to see. If you didn't want to do that, as I mentioned, you can just choose to wall mount it straight onto the wall like that. Now, one question someone asked to me and said, well, if I mount it like this onto the wall, what happens with inclement weather? If it starts raining, yes, you're going to get rain that runs down the lens and it's going to make the image not that great, really. Which is why we do actually sell these things. Look at the size of this thing. This is actually a rain cover for the dome cameras. So that's on the wall. And the idea being you can install that over the top just so. So that'll obviously prevent the rain getting onto the camera itself. These covers, again, I'll pop the link into the comments below. That just gets mounted straight onto the wall there. You can see with the little holes on the back there. It does have a little rain channel that gathers in there and it just drips down the side thus so. So again, if you are going to wall mount these dome cameras, I do suggest you actually buy the actual rain shield for them as well, just so that doesn't distort the image at all on there. These cameras are on their way in stock as we speak, but they are available for pre-order. Again, link is in the description below. Hopefully you liked the video. If you did, don't forget to like the video. Please do subscribe to the channel if you've not already done so. And don't forget that bell icon. That way you'll be alerted when we upload any new videos.